Hey guys, Webster here with part two of my Coach Gun project. Today is the fun one. We're going to cut the barrel. First thing you want to do whenever you handle any gun is make sure it is unloaded. Nothing in the chamber there, there's no magazine to remove, and the bores are clear. That guy is safe. So the thing you need to know if you're going to do this yourself, you can't just lop the barrel off wherever you want. There is a minimum length you can cut to before you start to enter criminal territory. That limit in Canada is 18 and a half inches, so you can't cut shorter than that. So you want to triple, quadruple measure, make sure that you're over that limit. Because if you cut the barrel off here, you're good to go, legal, law-abiding gun owner, take it out hunting, do what you want. Cut it off here, you are a hardened criminal looking at mandatory minimum 3 years in jail. So be sure, leave yourself some insurance barrel. What I'm going to do, I'm going to cut this to 20 inches. It's a nice even number, plenty short for my purposes, lots of insurance barrel. And commercial coach guns are 20 inches anyway. And if I decide I want it a little shorter, I can cut it back to 19. I probably won't go any shorter than that just to be on the safe side. You wouldn't think a tape measure can be open to interpretation, but I'd rather play it safe. All right, so the first thing I want to do is measure my barrel just to see what I'm working with. Standard way to do this is with the action closed and the gun unloaded, insert a cleaning rod from the muzzle end until you hit the breech face. Mark the rod with your finger, pull it back out, and measure 30 inches. So from there, it is just simple subtraction. Take my measuring tape, measure 10 inches from the muzzle, which will give me 20 inches of barrel left. I'll just mark the finish with a little file there so I know where to cut. And that's it. So now that my barrels are measured, I want to remove them from the gun before cutting them. So the first thing to do is remove the forend. These will vary a little bit depending on the gun. Some will have a lever here you pull on to release it. This one is just a little button to press, and that pops off. We'll set that aside. And now to remove the barrel, we open the action like we did before. And they just slide right off. There's our barrels removed from the gun, ready for cutting. So I've decided to use a miter box and a hacksaw to make this cut. Seems to me it's the simplest way to just get a nice straight line. I've heard of different ways you can do it. You can make it as simple or as complicated as you want. I'm just going to go this route. Like I said, it seems to be the easiest way to go about it. I'll still need to clean up the muzzle a little bit, just even everything out, but I think this is, for me, this is the way to go. All squared up there. Line up the blade with the mark I made earlier. Starting nice and slow. Barrel's trying to dance around on me a little bit there. See if I can't clamp it into place. Hold it a little tighter. That ought to work. Cut all straight. Still level? Good, good. All right. So there's the cut edge. Just needs some cleaning up. A little file and some very fine sandpaper. Get to work on that. Try to keep it even all the way around. Just move in this direction. Just clean up the whole outside. Check all your edges. I can run my finger along there. I'm not tearing it up. All good. All nice and smooth. There we are. Nice and clean. Alright, and I'm just going to run a lightly oiled patch down each bore just to clear out any junk that's still in there. There is some. Working from the breech end out. That's one. And the other one. There we go. And there are a couple of clean bores. Nice and smooth.